trust you. Hello, everyone, and welcome to the second installment of IDTV 2017. We're your hosts, Brad Winch.
And I'm Thelma Annan, and indeed, it's great to be back for another round of videos made by the advanced video production students at City College of San Francisco. We take a look into a reflection piece by Jessica Baker and Bob Hollingworth. They tell us what it means to be a gamer and the potential stigmas it may create in our society today, titled, We Are Gamers.
Then, up next, we explore what automation is as Aaron Aronjo and Scott Franklin uncover the effects it will have on the economy, workplace, and social structures for the future.
To close it all off, we have a DJ battle with two of San Francisco's hottest upcoming DJs, where they show off their skills on the turntables and find out who will reign supreme.
The DJs must spin it to win it. A loaded show for you all, only on IDTV 2017. Right now, we start with a parody investigative report produced by Samaya Salimi on a certain crime happening within the BEMA department that could very well prevent CCSF's free tuition.
An investigation? How did you even hear about that? It's supposed to be on the hush-hush.
I might have used my security clearance to check out some files.
That's only in case of emergencies. Is it serious?
Yeah. This could go all the way to the top of the broadcast department.
I'm sensing a scandal underway.
There's only one person who can crack this wide open.
Who?
Sherry O'Carey.
The Sherry O'Carey? The world's premier investigator of CCSF crimes? Well, let's follow her lead with Deep Inside CCSF.
Community colleges around the world are in fierce competition for federal and state funding. When a local San Francisco community college won the jackpot, confirming that all students attending wouldn't have to pay tuition, they did what any school would do. They went bonkers. Hi, I'm Sherry O'Carey, and tonight we bring our focus to City College of San Francisco, where the best thing that could have happened happened to be the worst thing that could have happened. When word got out that CCSF was going to be free to San Francisco residents, students, particularly in the broadcasting department, ran amok. Deep Inside CCSF crew broke the story and ran a detailed investigative report on what exactly was going on. We sent out our own Holly Hingleberry to find out how something so dramatic and stupid could happen.
Not too long ago, these halls were filled with students overjoyed that the troubles were over. College tuition was free. Something students around the country will kill their parents for. Our story leads us to an unlikely place. This is A160A, a simple computer lab equipped with state-of-the-art production and editing software. The last place you would think any action could ever happen. Now we enter the crime scene.
It was February 4th. I got to the lab at 6 a.m. like I always do. The lab was closed, of course, so I decided to dance away any negative energy. Robert wasn't there. When he arrived, I let him know that the lab needed to be opened.
Good morning, Robert.
I know Daniel uses the computer lab all the time, so I didn't think it'd be a problem to let him in a few hours early. I couldn't stand watching him dance any longer.
I'm classically trained.
I can tell. You have a great physique.
Daniel Dangle, seemingly innocent and eager student, gets to the lab early. He starts working when he notices something just isn't right.
I turned on the computer and set myself up. It was Monday morning, so I did like I always do. I walked around and made sure every computer was wiped down and allowed to air dry. I used my mouth to air dry. It's better for the machines.
Something Daniel noticed was what would become the demise of CCSF's accreditation and what would end free tuition before it even started.
Daniel called me over, so I ran over. Somebody left the speaker on over the weekend, so I turned it off and turned it back on, and it worked just fine.
So you're telling me that Daniel called you over, and then you went over, And then you turn on the speaker and it worked fine?
That's exactly what I just said.
I reported it to every supervisor in a 10-mile radius. It was the right thing to do.
I know exactly what you mean.
I don't think you do.
A simple problem with a simple solution was now in public view.
I don't feel bad that tuition went up. I don't feel bad at all. I don't think I can feel.
Amidst all of the commotion and anger that developed from the loss of accreditation and tuition hikes, CCSF students demanded to know who the culprit really was.
This is bullspit. I'm not gonna have my God-given rights taken away from me just because some sociopath left the speaker on. Right?
Unfortunately, cameras were turned off the weekend before the event occurred, leaving no way of finding out who committed the act of recklessness.
I decided to personally hire a team of investigators to examine the scene. Oh, we collected hair samples, the dirt around the keys on the keyboard, and oddly enough, there was a wisdom tooth by one of the monitors. Oh, and we have rats.
2 weeks went by, and still no signs of the culprit.
I don't know why I didn't think of this before. Daniel was the last person in the computer lab every night, and he was the first one there every day. Everybody knew this was coming.
It wasn't me.
Well, we got down to the bottom of that crime in record time. Thank you for tuning in, and as always, we'll leave you with a safety tip. When using public bathrooms, remember to use a minimum of 4 seat covers. See you next time, and stay safe, America. It's really cold in here. Can you get someone to get me my jacket, please?
Talent needs their jacket. Can you get it to them?
What's this?
It's your jacket.
What's your name?
Jose.
Jose. Okay, get this out of my face.
When you hear gamer, what words would you normally associate with it?
You're most likely going to hear the word nerd, lethargic, or lazy.
But despite such stigmas, video games have been more mainstream than ever. Whether it be Call of Duty or Candy Crush, there are games made for everyone.
As these games grow in number, so do the players. And who better to ask these questions than Master Chief himself from the critically acclaimed series Halo?
Oh my goodness, it's Master Chief. How are you?
Well, what brings you on the show today?
My people, the gamers.
And what is your mission for your people?
To break the stereotypes forced upon us.
Well, that sounds courageous. What are these gamer stereotypes you're out to destroy?
That we only think about games and nothing else.
And with that said, 2 BEMA students were game enough to ask the question, what is a gamer nowadays and what are the potential stigmas attached to such a label?
The negative stereotypes that gamers have is that, you know, we're lethargic, we're lazy, we don't really commit to things.
If you look at a picture of the stereotypical gamer, the guy will be obese. It'll be a guy, for sure. Because girls don't play video games, right? Which we all know isn't true at all. Acne-ridden, Funyun dust covering their unshaven face. We know the stereotypes.
I think a lot of people are aware of it, of the gamer stuck in the basement, you know? Although where I grew up, there weren't any basements, so it'd be the gamer stuck under the hut or something, you know? Or stuck in a room just playing and like avoiding sunlight.
The general audience always has like this negative stigma towards video games, and that shouldn't be the case whatsoever.
My name is Tossie, and I am a gamer, an actor, filmmaker.
What's love at first sight, anyway? He sees me. He sees me not. He sees me.
My name is Jordan Tayer. I'm the Influencer Relations Manager at Twitch. I've been involved broadcasting on Twitch for almost 6 years.
Howdy folks, Soma here again on the Twitch Live stage at TwitchCon in lovely San Francisco, California. You already knew that though, because you've been watching us for 2 days. We're gonna talk about Operation Supply Drop, one of my favorite charities. As a vet, I always think of Operation Supply Drop when I think charities on Twitch.
So my name is Daniel Kelly. I go by Woody Style on the internet as a professional gamer. Right now, I am an entrepreneur and esports enthusiast and ambassador for multiple brands. I'm also a Twitch streamer, so I'm a personality on the internet.
But for real, how do you have 150, 170 ping, Rudy?
No idea. We all got high ping.
I grew up as the kid that wasn't really into sports. I very much wanted to play GoldenEye 007 with my friends all day, every day. And I was always told that games weren't going to do anything for my future.
And so I'll get people, you know, making comments about my hair immediately. And that's how we are as people, right? Like, we immediately make observations. And so I think some of the stereotypes are like, yo, you're chubby, your hair is unruly sometimes. You know, some people will find it unruly. Or like, we'll make some kind of assumption on my race. You know what I'm saying? And I just shrug it off because I understand that people can be, you know, ignorant.
Whenever I think gamer, I can't really put a face to it anymore. It's men and women. It's black, white, Christian, Buddhist. It doesn't matter who you are. You can find something to do with games, and you'll have a great time. So I don't think there's a stereotype anymore. I think the stereotype has melted away. I could be wrong, but I think I'm right.
As technology evolves, it caters to our every need and makes our lives much easier. Think about it. If I have a place to go, I can simply grab my phone and call any Lyft or Uber, and in about 5 minutes, I'm in someone else's car. Or no one's car, with all those driverless automobiles some states are using. And I'll be where I need to go in about 20 minutes, max. And what if I'm hungry, and I'm just too lazy to talk to anyone on the phone, or put on some pants and get out of the house? No one wants to do that. So I go on Postmates and simply click on any food I want, and it's there in an hour or less. Ain't it great? When technology is easy, so is life. Right? I guess not all jobs can be replaced by androids. Let's head on over to Aaron and Scott's video, Automation.
Every day, a vast portion of society is in the presence of a technology that is continuously advancing, relentlessly, monotonously. This technology goes about its day as the sun rises and sets, much as we do, in our shadows, on our periphery, whether we understand or are even consciously aware of its existence. This technology, artificial intelligence, or AI, continues to grow and shape our daily lives. In order to get a better sense, we need to know and understand a few things. What exactly is artificial intelligence? In simple terms, artificial intelligence is a subfield of computer science. The goal of artificial intelligence is to enable the development and expansion of computers that are able to do things ordinarily done by people.
The theory, right, or the development of a computer so that it can complete and perform a task that would normally require a human or human intelligence.
AI, I think, starts from basic algorithms, call it a recipe, that you can take into machines that then, with these instructions, try to replicate human thinking.
Stanford researcher John McCarthy, an American computer scientist, finally coined the term in 1956 during what is now called the Dartmouth Conference, where the core mission of the artificial intelligence field was defined.
Machines. How smart can machines become? What are the limits of artificial intelligence?
Well, I see no limit short of human intelligence, and then with faster machines, one could do the equivalent that a human could do in a short time in a very long time.
Some examples of AI technology include automation, machine learning, deep learning, machine vision, natural language process, and robotics.
What we use it a lot for now in the real world is pattern recognition, recognizing faces, recognizing speech. It's also an entire class of programming called machine learning, where the machines learn to solve new problems on their own.
So eventually machines trying to replicate what humans are doing, but optimizing for better speed and better performance.
I think a lot of people, though, when they think of AI, they go Hollywood, and what they're really thinking of is not intelligence, but it's consciousness. It's self-awareness, and that's a whole different question in my mind.
How will artificial intelligence impact society?
I see this beautiful future where everything is like completely synchronized and working, but then I think, but then where's all the people?
Yeah, so that is the downside of artificial intelligence, is if you develop a machine that's so knowledgeable, so aware, so able to gather data, it can potentially beat, right, the people that even make it.
What's going to happen next? Is everybody of us going to have to be a developer? Are we going to have to teach our kids only to program? So that's where the thing gets like a little like scary for me, I would say, on AI.
And I don't think you need to be a developer necessarily to be in the future with AI. You'll still need people that design the way a robot's going to look, whether it's a painter or an industrial designer designing the shell. So no matter where the future goes, you're always going to have new jobs that come up surrounding that field. And AI, I think, is no different.
The other thing I see that I'm excited about is maybe a new revolution in work. So we had like the Industrial Revolution, where manual labor fell onto machines and people were then freed up to do information labor. So now we've got like an information labor driven society. When the information work is automated, that's going to free up people to do a new kind of work. And what that next work is going to be, we don't know, but my personal hope is that creativity will be more valued.
The difference with AI is that it can take creative jobs. It can take jobs that were formerly done by artists, by skilled people, and that's not necessarily a bad thing, but it may be if you're one of those skilled people and find yourself without a job.
It seems our future lies in a sea of algorithms, with machines that communicate with each other as fast as the neurotransmission of our own brains. As with any new form of technology that makes our lives easier, there are unforeseen predicaments that will have to be solved. It is our responsibility to educate ourselves and pass along the tools and knowledge to future generations. Hopefully, as a species, we will make choices in which these technologies serve us and not us to serve them.
Hey everybody, we got ourselves a party up in here. You know what that means? It's time for DJ Battle Spin It to Win It. Yep, that's right. We put two San Francisco-based DJs together in this room to find out who's willing to spin it to win it. First off, we have DJ Helifat. Come join me over here, fam. Come on over. All right, how are you doing?
Great, great.
Good. All right. So we all know it's festival season going on. So for everyone who can't afford it, who can't afford to leave the city, where can they go to listen to you play?
They can always come to 1501 Folsom. Calle Once is the name of the club. My name is DJ Helifat. You can always find me there. Check the calendar on the website. Thank you.
Okay, great. Thank you. And speaking of DJ playing, I love giving requests, song requests. How do you feel about song requests? Should we do it? Should we not?
I feel like I'm always down to play a song request if it's a great song, and there's always more incentive if they leave a tip or buy me a drink or something like that.
All right, buy your man a drink, guys. We can listen to some Beyonce. No Bieber, please. I mean, that's 2014. All right, and to our left, we have DJ Mike Cool. Come on over. How are you doing?
Pretty good. How are you?
Good. So what's the misconception about being a DJ?
One thing I would say is that DJs are not iPods. So don't come to the DJ booth requesting a song and expecting me to play the song right away. You gotta give me time to mix the next record.
All right. This isn't Spotify. This isn't Apple Music. He is human. Calm yourself. And where can your new and old fans go to listen to you play in San Francisco?
So me and my friend, Hype Man SF, we throw a party every Wednesday at Skylark Bar, and it's on 16th and Valencia, and we're there from 10 to 2 every Wednesday.
Okay, great. You guys heard him. Now, are you guys ready? Are you ready? All right, so the rules are simple. The DJs go back and forth against each other in 2-round intervals. We each get 1 minute and then another round for another minute, going back and forth. We have our 3 celebrity judges in the corner, and they'll decide with their lovely 2-sided paddles who the winner is. Now, without further ado, I need y'all to get to your corners. I need you to pump it up. And we're gonna get ready. All right, Brad, our official is gonna do the coin toss. Come on down, like the price is right. All right, so DJ Helifat, you're gonna be heads. DJ Mike, you're gonna be tails. And?
Tails.
Tails. DJ Mike, do you wanna go first or second? Second, okay, number 2, DJ Helifat, it's your time. Let's go. We'll be right back. everybody. Welcome back to our performances. They were super fire. How did you feel about it?
Felt great.
Good. All right. And how about you?
That was pretty good. Can't wait for the results.
All right. Let's get it started. Right now, we're going to meet our celebrity guest judges. Up first, we have Miss Jen Rowe. She's the Bay Area famous rapper. How are you doing today, girl?
Doing good. Enjoying the show.
All right. And where can people find you?
You can find me at Jen Rowe Music or just hashtag Jen Rowe, jenrowe.net. New album, Planet Z, and thanks for all the support.
All right, great. So tell us how you felt about DJ Helifat's performance.
DJ Helifat, you were on point. Everything sounded good. I like the song selection that you had, combining, you know, the reggaeton with the West Coast and then also having a faster electronic song. So that was a good versatility with the song selection. There was a little bit of latency between the you know, the beats and the transition, but I think overall you did a great job.
Great. And up next, we have Infected Frequencies. He is a DJ and audio instructor. How did you feel about DJ Mike's performance?
I thought DJ Mike Cool's performance was pretty dope. His track selection, and in particular that one track, Gwen Stefani's Bananas, was pretty much one of my favorites. And the way that the crowd that we had was interacted with him, the way that some of the tracks he was playing, it's pretty dope. It was obviously that, you know, they were in favor of him. So, you know what I'm saying? We'll see, you know, what Charisma has to say. But, you know, I feel like Mike Cool definitely had, you know, an upper hand on this battle.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
All right. So, Charisma Keesh, you are the deciding factor, basically.
Oh,
Infected Frequencies put everything on you. You are a radio personality. Tell us where people can hear your amazing voice every morning, afternoon, and night.
Yes. So, my show is 2UP Radio on ADP.FM. That's short for All Day Play. You can Google search my name, Charisma Keesh, and find all my social media to keep up with all the projects that I have going on. Thank you guys so much for letting me come and be a judge. This was very exciting for me to see both of you guys. You guys did great. I like each of your guys' song selections. Like they mentioned as well, you guys actually kind of threw me for a loop when you were playing. I was like, wait a second, that was dope how they just slid that in there like that. What I would say for both of you guys though is to kind of practice with the timing, with the effects, so that it doesn't get off beat and throw off the overall sound as a whole. So just practice with that a little bit more, but overall, you guys are doing good.
All right, great. Do you guys have any final words before we give out the winner?
Yeah, sure. DJ Helifat, you could find me on Spotify, SoundCloud, Apple Music, and all the digital distributors. I'm also on social media. Thank you guys for the opportunity, and it's been a privilege. Thank you.
Great. Once again, I go by DJ Mike Cool. You could find me on Instagram at It's Mike Cool. And I just thank you for having the opportunity for me to come out here.
Okay, awesome. And now it's the moment we've all been waiting for. All of our judges are going to flip over their panels to reveal a winner. Drum roll, please. One, two, three. Oh, it looks like it's DJ Mike Cool unanimously. There's a beautiful trophy by Brad. Thank you so much. Here's our beautiful Brad with the trophy. Congratulations. Do you want to thank anybody?
I just want to thank my hands for allowing me to do work on the turntables. And I want to give a shout out to Felix for letting me come out here and just competing, and to the judges. Thank you again. Appreciate it.
Thelma, thank you so much, guys. Thank you for all the time that we have here for DJ Battle Spin It to Win It and for IDTV Episode 2. We would like to thank you, the viewer, for watching. And don't forget to follow us on social media such as Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at IDTV Show. And we'll see you next time. Bye.
I'm making you know since Dimension in Kingston, Jamaica, representing, I'm making you know. Live and direct with the champion sound. DJ Mike Cool and the ones and twos for the culture. I
Yo, just give me the lines and pass the joe. What's another